Hello, beloved of the Lord. Welcome to this channel. Today we're just going to do a quick teaching and prayer based on John chapter 10, verse 10. And it's about the abundant life that Jesus came to give us. The entire chapter starts off by saying Jesus is the true shepherd. Some other translation says Jesus is the good shepherd. And from verse 7 of John chapter 10, it says Jesus is the good shepherd, right? So Jesus is our good shepherd. Psalm 23 also tells us that the Lord Jesus is our shepherd. Let us pray before we get into this word. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus for the power of Holy Spirit to equip us, to teach, to guide, and to lead us into all truth, that we may live the life you call us to live and to build your kingdom here on earth. Have your way, your will be done, and your kingdom come in Jesus' name. Amen. John chapter 10, verse 10 says, "The thief does not come except to steal, to kill, and to destroy." So the thief comes to do three things: to steal, to kill, and to destroy. "I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly." So the thief comes to do three things: to kill and destroy. And Jesus came to do one thing: to give us the abundant life, right? He started off by saying, "I have come that they," which is those of us who have reconciled to him and to the Father through the sacrifice of Jesus, that he came that we may have life, and not just life, that we may have life more abundantly. So right off before we start, I want you to declare with me, "I have life and I have it more abundantly." Other translation says that you would have life that is full. You have a satisfied life, a life that is overflowing, which means your life is going to be so good and prosperous that it will not only benefit you, but everybody else around you. We have a few videos on this same teaching in similar versions of it. There's a short video with no voice on it, just music and the scripture. And there's another teaching that talks about this. So you might want to go on to our channel and view those videos as well. And before we go on, if you have not subscribed, please go ahead and click the subscribe button and hit the notification button as well, so that whenever there's a new video, you'll be notified. Now, the aim of this video is to offer a prayer to address the issue that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is highlighting and drawing our attention to. He is saying the thief does not come except to steal, to kill, and to destroy. So right away, we're going to pray. We're going to pray and ask the Lord to do a few things. First of all, to reverse everything that the enemy has stolen, killed, and destroyed, and also to put a stop to every plan of the evil one to steal, kill, and destroy, whether in our present or in our future, in our lives, in every area of our life. So let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We bless you for your word that is life, your word that illuminates, your word that directs, your word that is a lamp unto our feet. In the name of Jesus, we are asking right now. Your word tells us in Proverbs 6, 30. And 31, that if a thief is found, he should be made to restore seven times what he's stolen. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, we decree and declare that everything that Satan and his demons have stolen be restored in the name of Jesus. We also speak life into every good thing that has prematurely died in our life, that the enemy has killed. Rakataba. We speak life. We say, "Come alive," in the name of Jesus. We also ask, Father, in the name of Jesus, that everything that the enemy has destroyed or withheld be restored in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Father, right now we have come boldly to your throne of grace, and we are asking. We thank you for hearing us every time we pray, that everything that the enemy has stolen is reversed and restored sevenfold. Everything that the enemy has killed, to receive resurrection power in the name of Jesus, is made alive again by the power of Holy Spirit. That everything that the enemy has destroyed, like the dry bones in Ezekiel 37, come alive in the name of Jesus. Come alive in the name of Jesus. Replenish in the name of Jesus and be fruitful in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We also know that your word says that you, Jesus, have come that we may have life and have it more abundantly. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, we ask, Lord, and we decree that we have the abundant life, the abundant life, the abundant life, the abundant life. We decree abundant life, life in abundance, a life that is full, a life that is full, a life that is prosperous, a life that overflows, a life that is satisfying, a life that through us, our families are blessed, our cities are blessed, our provinces are blessed, our states are blessed, our countries are blessed, our entire generation is blessed because of us. In the name of Jesus, 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 masukete berebede makataba rikataba reketeben reketeben. We decree abundant life rekataba. We also ask that there'll be no more further stealing, killing, or destruction in the name of Jesus. Father, that you issue a verdict in your heavenly throne room. You are our righteous judge to stop the enemy of anything that he plans to steal, kill, or destroy, either in our present life, in the lives of our spouses, of our children, of our friends, of our loved ones, of the people we work with, of our cities, of our lineage. In the name of Jesus, we say no. We say no to any more stealing, any more killing, any more destruction. We say no. We say no. Be it today, this week, this month, this year, this decade, or forevermore, we say no. We stop the enemy in his track. We renounce every agreement that we may have made, consciously or unconsciously, with stealing, with killing, with destruction. We say no. We renounce every agreement that we may have made with dead, hell, and the grave. And we say no. We speak life. We speak life. We speak life. We speak life. We decree that we have life and more abundantly. We have life and more abundantly. In the name of Jesus, we receive the length of days. Father, in the name of Jesus, that our youth are renewed like that of an eagle. We decree prosperity of increase. Everything that the enemy has withheld through the bloodline, we decree a release in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Every generational blessing that has been withheld, that has been hidden, that has been covered, we decree a release right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Makotobo rikata sekete rekete rekata masakata bababa rekata barabu shan. We receive the abundant life, Lord. We thank you for the abundant life, Lord, in every area of our life. Abundance, life, and more abundantly in our families, in our marriages, in our relationships, in our finance, in our ministry, in the work of our hands, in our businesses, in our cities, physical life, spiritual life, emotional life, financial life, social life, life in every facet of it, everything under our influence, come alive, come alive, come alive. Every good thing that has died, come alive in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Mekataba rukataba reketebedebedebedebe sandabu kata rekataba, in the name of Jesus. And we seal this prayer by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the power of Holy Spirit. Father, we are also asking not just for restoration, for punitive damages as well. Everything good that should have accompanied the things that the enemy stole, killed, and destroyed, my Lord, the opportunities, the joy, the peace, the enlargement, the increase, the advancement, the laughter, the graces, the territories, everything good that should have accompanied those days, those things that were stolen, those things that were killed, those things that were destroyed. We ask for the speed of the Holy Spirit to catapult, to accelerate us back to wherever we should have been by now. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let every setback be reversed. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your acceleration, speed of the Holy Ghost, let the spirit of Elijah accelerate us, break and negate, overhaul every delay, brought about by stealing, killing, and destruction. In the name of Jesus, we receive abundant life and everything good that comes with them. We receive abundant life, we receive knowledge, we receive wisdom, we receive discernment, we receive increase, we receive insight, good stewardship of everything that you have already made available to us. Your word tells us that you have given us everything that pertains to life and godliness. We receive these blessings in the name of Jesus. Your word also tells us that no good thing do you withhold from those that you love, that you are akata. Every good and perfect gift comes from you, comes from you. Every good and perfect gift, we receive every good and perfect gift in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, right now, today, in the name of Jesus, we decree and declare that as Jesus has agreed with us on this prayer and the Holy Spirit makes intercession for us, we decree this prayer sealed by the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, and backed by you, Lord, we thank you that whatsoever we ask, we are received in the name of Jesus, so that our joy may be made full. We give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor. In Jesus' name have we prayed. Brethren, I'll be waiting, looking out for your testimonies, for good things that are coming your way, and the release of all that God has for you. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you so much. That's why he encouraged me to do this prayer that I've been hesitant to do since last week. But God loves somebody very much and wants somebody to receive these blessings and to be aware. You want to repeat this prayer over and over again, and I'll also be praying with you. And I can't wait to hear from you. God bless you. Stay blessed and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.